both dance. Jacqueline
Beth, Emma Janoschak, Canada.
Well, here are Jacqueline Peter and Mark Janoschak of Brampton, Ontario. 12th after the first compulsory dance. And Barb, you had a chance to chat with her just a few moments ago.
I did, and they were relatively pleased with their first dance, but Jackie said she was in quite a bit of pain towards the end of the dance. She did say, however, though, that this dance will be a little bit easier on her injury.
I would have to think that up at the village, the Canadian skaters have been comparing notes on injuries between Jackie getting spiked, Michael pulling the muscles in his neck, and Kurt and Elvis coming in with injuries previous to this. They must be keeping the physio team quite busy up there. Job of keeping the flow up in this dance, and it's tough to do in this one because you have to keep moving, you have to keep covering the ice, and yet you don't want to look like you're having to work at it to achieve that.
What I like about them are their very deep knees. They really sit into their edges.
Well, the injury to Jacqueline certainly raised the issue once again about the fact Canada's only sent one dance team here when they did have two eligible. Mann and Urrea were forced to stay at home, and it would have been a real shame had we not had anyone skate in this competition because of her injury.
Well, Jackie did say to me that it did add pressure to them because of the fact that they wanted to skate. They didn't want Canada not to have an entry in this event.
Well, they were 12th after the first compulsory, and they are 12th again, despite the fives from Canada and Italy. So Jacqueline Peter and Mark Janoschak with identical 12th place finishes in both compulsory dances. So the standings are the same at the top of both compulsory dances. Glebova Ponomarenko, then Usova Zulin, and the Ducheneys in third place. Jacqueline Peter and Mark Janoschak were 11th after the first compulsory dance, 12th after the second. And after the competition, I asked Jackie about her injured leg and how it held up on the first day of competition.
Last night, basically, we went on practice. Things felt all right, and I decided that this was, you know, too important, and things were feeling pretty good. And we decided that there was no way we could not do it. So we sort of made up our minds last night and decided to go through with it.
How did it feel?
Scary. Very, very scary. I didn't know whether I'd get through the whole dance, and then whether to do the second dance was sort of, you know, far in the future. During practices yesterday, we had only done one round of each of the dances, the Paso, and we had to do three rounds of the Paso today, and I was very nervous about that. And through the Paso today in the competition, it did hurt a lot.
Mark, under the circumstances, are you happy with the results?
I couldn't be more happy. I'm very pleased, considering on Wednesday she couldn't even walk, and to get out there and skate, you know, as well as we did, we can't be more pleased.
So after the compulsory dances, the Ducheneys are in the same position they were in at last year's World Championships in Munich. Barb, any disadvantage in that?
Well, last year in Munich, the Ducheneys proved that they can come from behind, but this year we have yet to see their original dance. We have yet to see their free dance. And judging from what we saw at the Europeans from the two Russian teams, it will be a tough battle for them.
Paul, each dance competition seems to have its own judging controversy.
We had some controversy here tonight, and it came from the French judge. After the first compulsory dance, she put up marks that put her team, the Duchesneys, in first place and put Klimova Ponomarenko in fourth place. There was much talk up here after that happened. In the second compulsory dance, she fell right into line, and I think we'll see her stay there for the balance of this competition.
All right, the original dance goes Sunday. Don't forget tomorrow the men's long program as Kurt Browning skates for gold. Right now, let's return you to Brian Williams.
All right, Chris, the final.